guys, and you were the chosen two to speak on behalf of their own Rosetown Kinsmen.
Yes, we were, and we're really excited to be here.
Good, I'm glad you guys came. So what kind of things have you been planning all year long?
So, my name is John McPhee, and I'm the president of the Rosetown Kinsmen, and this is my friend and fellow kin, Pete. And like I said, we're so excited to be here. Today, we've got a memorial donation. James Clifford Simpson Cliff was born on September 21st, 1920. He passed away June 21st, 2020. Cliff was born on the farm 18 miles north of Rosetown. He farmed and lived in this home for 80 years until he and his wife Joyce moved to Rosetown. Together, they raised 5 children. The family has now expanded to 31 offspring plus spouses. Cliff's passion was his herd of Charolais cattle. He was a founding member of the Saskatchewan Charolais Association, and this led to so many friendships with other Charolais breeders. Over the years, Cliff served on many boards and committees in various roles, and he was always ready to lend a hand to neighbors when in need. The Seniors Club and the Seniors Choral Group became very important to him after moving to Rosetown. When work was required, he was happy to oblige. Cliff knew most of the people in Rosetown by name, and he enjoyed meeting them on the street for a quick hello. Looking after his wife and family were always a top priority to Cliff. Giving to others was also important to Cliff and Joyce as they supported many charities. Kinsmen Tell a Miracle was always a charity close to their hearts. So today, Joyce is donating $10,000 to Kinsmen Tell a Miracle in memory of Cliff Simpson.
Wow, that's fantastic. Excellent. Well, we can't ask for anything more from Cliff, man, I tell you. He must have been a good guy.
Thanks, John. And from the community of Rosetown, we have the Walter Asseltine Elementary School raised $2,290. The Central High School raised $1,563. Our Kinsmen Club raised $2,452. And we had a community donations of $900 and miscellaneous of $1,040 for a grand total of $8,246.37.
Wow.
From Rosetown.
You guys came through again. Thank you very much. Wow, over $18,000 just for being here for 2 minutes with a whole year long of work.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, thank you so much for coming this way. And we're going to count such generous people in Rosetown. We're so thankful for you guys being here and thankful for the community as well.
Ring those phones, Saskatchewan, and go Rosetown.
Go Rosetown and ring those phones. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to go live to a great sponsor and a great help for Tell a Miracle, Sarcan. I think we have Sean on the line. Are you there, Sean? Hello, Sean, are you there?
Hi, Brad. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Yeah, go ahead.
Perfect. Yeah. Sarcan is thrilled to once again be part of this great tradition of Saskatchewan residents and businesses supporting Kinsmen Tell a Miracle. This is the 18th consecutive year that Sarcan has been a Tell a Miracle sponsor. We couldn't be happier.
Yeah, wow, you guys have done so much.
Yeah, it's really exciting to see how our employees across the province get behind Tell a Miracle. They're incredible ambassadors. They sell tens of thousands of helping hands every year. And in addition to that, we raise funds year-round through our drop and donate service. So I'd really encourage Saskatchewan residents to generously continue to donate using that service. It's a safe and quick and efficient way to donate to Tell a Miracle. At any Sarcan depot in the province, you just simply type in Tell a Miracle when you're asked for the group phrase. The great thing is 100% of your donation will go directly to Tell a Miracle. So when we combine those two amounts, the helping hands with the drop and donate, results in a pretty incredible donation every year. So on behalf of the over 700 recyclers across the province, I want to proudly present Sarcan with a check for $51,139.55. And I have a couple of helpers here to present the check.
Okay, look at that. $51,139.55 from Sarcan. Every year, you come through so fantastic for us all, and it's with such enthusiasm too. We miss this year going around to the Sarkans and visiting with the employees and staff, and we hope to be able to go out and see everybody again next year. But again, fantastic, over $50,000 for Telemiracle, and that's again with people donating their SoCan bags as well. So again, thanks, Sean, for who's helping out in the background there.
So I've got Seamus and Ainsley. They were they filled in. Normally we'd be doing this in person and on stage, but they were happy to help out. And again, I just want to say a huge thank you to all of our amazing employees, to our very generous customers, and of course to Telemiracle for all the great work you do. Supporting local communities and local individuals year-round, year-in, year-out. So thanks, Brad.
Thank you very much, Sean, and continued success with the Sarkan program. Bye-bye.
Take care, everybody.
Yeah. Okay, that's fantastic.
Thanks, Brad. Thank you, Rosetown. Thank you, Sarkan. There's a real electricity in the air here at Telemiracle right now. We're getting donations coming in from all over the province through these great fundraising efforts, and we're going to move not too far from the Rosetown vicinity. We're going to go over to Vanscoy now. We're going to hear from Amy Blom. I think we have a group of three who are going to join me via live video here. There we are. Hello, Vanscoy. How are you doing?
Hi!
So great to see you. So another fantastic act of Saskatchewan talent who's joining us on Telemiracle. Your pre-recorded video is going to play in a second. Well, we get a few seconds to chat with you here first. Tell me a little bit about what you're going to sing, perhaps.
We're going to be singing Glory of Love by Peter Cetera from Rowdy King Part 2.
Glory of Love, fantastic, fantastic choice. And also, you have to tell me about the name of your band. It's quite interesting. So first of all, what is the name of your band?
Okay, so we called ourselves the Bum Band because growing up, our dads would often call us a bunch of lazy bums. So we turned that into our band name. But what's funny is we have a brother who we tried to convince to join our band, but he wouldn't. So the biggest bum is not actually in the Bum Band.
I love it. You owned it. Your dad tried to give you a bad name, and you owned it. So hats off to you. Now, we're going to get to your song really quickly here, but tell me, you did bring a donation. Can you tell me quickly the donation and maybe how you raised it? Quick.
So we raised $920. We held a live stream on Facebook and YouTube, and we just invited our family and friends, and they all donated, which is awesome.
Thank you so much for your generosity of your donations, the generosity of your talent. We appreciate everything. The Bum Band from Vanscoy, Saskatchewan, and the Glory of Love. Thank you.
Tonight is very clear, as we're both lying here. There's so many things I wanna say. I will always love you, I will never leave you alone. Sometimes I just forget, say things I might regret. It breaks my heart to see you crying. I don't wanna lose you, I could never make it alone. I am a man who will fight for your. I have always needed you. I can- could never make it alone. I am a man who will fight for your honor. I'll be the hero you've been dreaming of. We'll live forever, knowing together that we did it. Like a knight in shining armor from a long time ago. Just in time, I'll save the day, take you to my castle far away.
So much, and make sure to ring those phones.
Much the Bum Band from Vanscoy, so Saskatchewan. Good. Fantastic playing. I want to join the Bum Band. They're amazing.
I love that song.
Now, of course, when they're playing, while they're playing, people have been dialing in. We've also had some great corporate presentations and donations of all different kinds, which means it's probably time to get a total to see where we're at here.
Oh, it's time.
Where are we
okay,
at, Saskatchewan? Help us count it out.
Here we go.
Three,
eight,
four. $680,483.
Yes. Isn't that nice how you just sweep across it?
And where are we going, everybody?
Higher.
That's right. Now over to Mr. Johnner. You got some more donations coming
up, we have a quick clip from Ramona Reimer, and she sold $250 worth of bracelets. And it's a quick clip, so let's watch it right now.
Hi, I'm Ramona Reimer. Mommy and me made bracelets. We sold them for $10. We made $250. Hooray! Have a good day.
Oh my gosh. Okay, we gotta watch that again because that is the cutest thing I've seen this morning.
Hi, I'm Ramona Lima. Mommy and me made bracelets. We sold them for $10. We made $250. Hooray! Have a good day.
Well, we are going to have a good day now, that's for sure. We go from something that cute to this. I don't know what just happened. How do you compete with that, guys?
You just can't.
You cannot.
We're just going to try to give more money.
That's right, give more money. Okay, yeah. Tell us who you are and where you're from.
My name is Trent Federichka, life member with the Melfort Kinsman Club.
Yes.
I'm Aaron Skifton, I'm president of the Melfort Kinsman Club this year.
Great.
So we'd like to speak on for our Canets this year. They did a pancake breakfast.
Yeah.
During that big minus 50 cold. Ooh. Things, so they had to get creative and do some fun ways to keep the pancakes warm. They also did a toilet drop this year, so you basically drop toilet off in your yard and you had to pay to get rid of it. It was lots of fun.
Great.
So yeah.
A couple other things too to mention too, on behalf of the memory of Norma McConaughey, passed away this past summer, and she made a donation to Tell a Miracle this year of $500. She was a huge community supporter and a big supporter of kin. So
wow.
Thank you to Norma and family
thank
for that.
You.
The Kin Clubs would also like to thank the following. It's been kind of a crazy year, and we haven't been able to do as much fundraising as we like to do, of course. Mm-hmm. I'd like to give a huge shout out to Miss Rose Bradley from the Caskey Place Tennis Association. Every year they take their coffee money and they put it in and to the fund, and they get a couple teddy bears at the end of the year. And this year they're able to raise up $850 wow. for us from the coffee fund. So wow. pretty cool. And thank you to all of them. We'd also like to thank Rayanne at RJ's Urban Garden for helping us with the pancake breakfast. That was okay. huge, awesome. Yeah. Also the Melfort Fire Brigade, the MUCC students and staff, Federich Insurance and Financial, Smith Agencies, the Melfort Rotary Club with their $1,000 donation, the Brunswick School, they did a mini miracle, a telemiracle carnival, sorry. Okay. And this year they broke their record and they were able to raise $3,899.45.
Wow.
So I'd also like to say, Brunswick School, where good choices happen. Oh, yeah. This brings us to our grand total
okay.
Raised from the Melfort and community of $22,418.12.
Wow. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Thank
over $22,000. The community, of course, Melfort is just a huge supporter of Telemiracle, the whole area. And again, through a pandemic, can still raise that kind of money and get together. It's fantastic.
It is. It's fantastic.
Yeah. So we appreciate you guys coming out again this year. And maybe next year it'll even be bigger and better.
That's right.
As long as we can keep the phones ringing.
That's right.
Okay. Thank you, gentlemen. Appreciate it.
All right, well, let's get to some more Saskatchewan talent coming all the way from Prince Albert. Looking out there for Maurice Villeneuve. Hello, Maurice. How are you?
Hello. I'm fine, thank you.
Well, good. Now, Maurice, now you did some fundraising for a donation to Telemiracle.
Yes, I have a few here. I collected $265. From Darlene Mackay, Sharon Fiddler, Carol and Dave Archibald, Holly, Brenda and Wendy, and myself and my wife.
Well, that is amazing. Well, we thank you so much for that. Now, this is your first time on Telemiracle, am I right? Oh, so everybody's going to be watching
yes,
out there
is.
In Prince Albert. That is so great. You're going to be singing and playing guitar. We look forward to this performance of you, Maurice. Thank you so much for joining us today.
same.
Thank you so much, Maurice Villeneuve from Prince Albert. It was so nice to hear your voice and see you here on Telemiracle. Now, we are always so grateful when we hear of stories of people who have planned to give to Telemiracle in their wills or when they passed. And so I'd like to talk about a very special person right now, William Anthony Stewart. William Anthony Stewart was born in 1930 and grew up in Melfort, Saskatchewan. Bill worked for his dad in the draying business, where he developed a love of horses. In 1957, Bill married Trixie Smith. They moved to Prairie River, Saskatchewan, where Bill worked in a lumber mill. A move took them to Swan River, Manitoba, where Bill worked in the livestock business and trained thoroughbred horses. He continued with the feedlot and cow-calf operation, which he later purchased. He began raising quarter horses and then ventured into Arabians and thoroughbreds. In 1994, they returned to Melfort and purchased land where they continued enjoying horses. Trixie passed away in 1998, and a couple years later, Bill returned to breeding horses, raising many foals and quarter horses. He enjoyed watching chuck wagon races, visiting the barns, and he continued riding until aged 85. He always enjoyed watching Telemiracle and the work they did for the people of Saskatchewan. Bill passed away in 2018. Kinsmen Telemiracle would like to thank Bill for his generous gift of $367,915.70. Wow. My goodness. William Bill Anthony Stewart. Thank you so much. Wow.
Andrea, thanks for sharing that story. Those stories, aren't they, they just grab you by the heart and make you just appreciate people's generosity so much.
What a generous man.
And knowing that the money's staying right here in Saskatchewan to help people, his neighbors, friends, people around the province, yeah. it's an incredible gesture.
Oh, it moved him, and now he's moving others.
Yeah, with all these examples of planned giving, it's incredible.
Yeah.
So, speaking of moving our hearts, I think we have something coming up that can that'll keep our hearts being moved. One thing we do as cast members, in addition to sort of trying to keep the show going as hosts, we perform every now and then.
Yes, we do.
And our very own Beverly Mahood and Mac Shepherd have prepared a little song for us. Take it away, Beverly and Mac.
Thank you so much, Beverly. This is a little sugar.
Let's do it.
All right.
I'm hurting, baby. I'm broken down. I need your loving, loving. I need it now. When I'm without you, I'm something weak. You got me begging, begging. I'm on my knees. I don't want to be needy. I just wanna be deep in your love, and it's killing me when you're away. Ooh, baby, cause I really don't care where you are. I just wanna be there where you are, and I gotta get one little taste. Your sugar, yes, please. Won't you come and put it down on me? I'm right here, cause I need little love, a little sympathy. Yeah, you show me good loving.
You pick them up. Don't leave me hanging, hanging. Come give me some. When I'm without you, so insecure. You are the one thing I'm living for.
I don't wanna be needy, your love. I just wanna be deep in your love. And it's killing me when you're away. Ooh, baby, cause I really don't care where you are. I just wanna be there where you are. And I gotta get one little taste. Your sugar.
This'll be the day that I die.
Here we go.
Doing a nice acoustic version there. Everybody in the studio is dancing, having a great time. Okay, I'm here with Jocelyn and Sawyer, and you guys hail from Demain, right?
Yeah.
And that's over, that's kind of around that Lake Diefenbaker area, right?
That's exactly.
So you had a little bit of a drive to get here.
We did.
Yeah?
But yeah, so we are from Demain.
Yes.
And as most of you know, Demain has a population of 17 people.
17.
So we take turns being the mayor.
Okay.
It's very easy. This year was Demain's 20th year raising money for Telemiracle. It was a big milestone for us. It all started at the Domain Hotel with Ned Petrie and Frank Berthelot and has grown into the fundraiser it is today. Like everyone else, we had to adapt and overcome to find a way to fundraise for our favorite telethon. So we had our annual auction, but we had it on Facebook.
Oh, perfect.
So a lot of people actually had to get Facebook to be a part of the fundraiser. Sure. And after about 2 dozen phone calls, I think we got it figured
Everybody
out.
Was on Facebook.
So businesses from Regina to Rosetown, Saskatoon to Swift Current, Outlook, and literally everywhere in between donated items. To make up for our usual supper, I went on a pledge run. I ran 15 kilometers on purpose, and I'm no means a runner. We also did a 50-50, and our Lucky Lake kinsmen donated money from their Chase the Ace fundraiser. Michaela Jessman with Life Captured Photography had a photo shoot and donated money there too. Over the last 2 decades, Domain has proudly donated $210,000 to Telemiracle. Thank you to every business, person, and organization that has helped this year and every year before. So now the numbers. My pledge run raised $3,700. The 50-50 raised $1,500. The auction raised $15,726.80. The Kinsmen donated $500. And Life Captured Photography donated $200. All of that added together and many other generous donations, I proudly present Telemiracle 45 with a Domain record donation of $23,376.80. We may be small, but together we are mighty.
Whew.
And Sawyer. And Sawyer would like to put a challenge out.
For all of the grade runners in Saskatchewan to raise...
To donate $5.
$5 for Telemiracle.
Hi, Grandma.
All the grade oneers? All the grade oneers in Saskatchewan to donate $5. That's your challenge.
That's the challenge.
Okay, well, the challenge has been accepted, and I'm pretty sure that we can handle $5 for every grade oneer out there. So you're doing a heck of a job. Are you the mayor this year?
No, I don't think, it's my turn.
It's your turn for
the mayor.
I think
it's my turn this year, yeah.
Okay, well, that's amazing. Over $23,000 from 17 people in the
and
town.
And the surrounding area.
And
We all really came together this year, and we knew it was going to be different, and we knew it was going to be hard.
Yeah.
But, you know, Saskatchewan's never backed down from a challenge.
And how many years has he been doing this?
20 years.
Oh,
this
was
our big one.
Well, we appreciate you doing that again for one more year for us. And maybe next year it'll be even better.
You bet it will be.
Thank you very much, Jocelyn. See you, Sawyer. Thank you.
Bye, wow, that great donation in from Domain. Over $20,000 from a small community and a $5 challenge to every grade oneer out there
the
in the province.
The grade oneers. Do you remember you're in grade one?
I'm not really, actually.
I can't. All right.
All these donations coming in,
yes.
I think it's time for a total.
I think that's a
Let's
great
see where
idea.
We're at, Saskatchewan. Shout it out.
8, 4, 3, 6, 9.
$3,296,348.
Wow. Where
awesome
are we going,
Saskatchewan?
Saskatchewan?
Oh, we're going higher.
Higher,
we're
higher
going
of course.
Higher.
We are going higher. That is incredible. Thank you so much, Saskatchewan. That is, there's electricity on the set here.
I
can
it.
Feel it. This is really incredible. Now, I'm seeing some posts on social media, actually. It's really fantastic that there's people, families gathered around their TVs watching. I hear of people getting so excited to see their names coming across the bottom of the screen when they've donated. And people are challenging each other, like to all the grade oneers out there. This feels like there's some incredible momentum going on with Telemiracle. And to keep the momentum going, we've got some more Saskatchewan talent to warm our hearts. We're going to have live via video here. We're going to be speaking with Bryn Cole from Saskatoon, I believe. Are you there, Bryn?
Yes.
Hello. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good. So I understand this is your first time. This is your big debut on Telemiracle.
Yes, it is.
We're excited to have you here. And you're going to be singing a song for us. Can you tell me a little bit about the song?
I'm going to be singing a song called You Are the Reason by Callum Scott.
Very cool. And any reason, is the song special to you for a certain reason?
I like the song when I first heard it, so I figured it would be pretty cool to sing it.
Very nice, very nice. And I understand you've also brought a donation. Can you tell us how much you brought and a quick little bit maybe on how you raised it? I'm really curious about your donation.
Yes, so our goal was $1,000, but as of today we raised $3,460 for Telemiracle.
$3,460, Bryn Cole from Saskatoon, thank you so much. So you're bringing us that gift of your donation and the gift of your wonderful singing. We're gonna get to see your pre-recorded.
I'm hopeless now. I climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to
goodness. Thank you, Bryn Cole. That was stunning. We so appreciate your hard work and your heart, because that is what this telethon is all about, bringing miracles, and that was beautiful. And here is another beautiful performer from Saskatchewan, our Saskatchewan talent, someone from Lucky Lake. Now, I have to say, Lucky Lake has been standing out. I keep hearing stories about these great fundraising things. So hi, Liam Jones. Nice to meet you.
Hi, how's it going?
Really well. Now, I hear you're going to be singing and playing piano for us, and this is your first time on Telemiracle, right?
Yes, this is my first time.
How are you feeling about that?
I'm feeling pretty good.
Oh, great. Well, welcome. Now, I don't know, the story of, the fundraising in Lucky Lake, you must have been inspired, or they were inspired by you. Tell us about your fundraising activities.
Yeah, well, we hosted an online concert, COVID safe, of course, with my friends and family, and we recorded it, pre-recorded it, and we put it on YouTube, and with that, we raised a total of $2,000.
Oh, $2,000. So, and you know that that's actually $4,000 because Nutrien matches your donation. So you actually got $4,000 for Telemiracle with your work. Thank you so much,
Thank
Liam.
Thank you, Nutrien.
Way to go. Yeah, I'm so thrilled. So we're excited to hear from Liam Jones from Lucky Lake. Here we go.
Awesome. Thank you.
I packed my bags last night pre-flight. Zero hour, 9 a.m. by then. I miss you so much, I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space.
All this amazing Saskatchewan talent. That was just incredible. Two in a row.
I mean, it's been happening so much this year. The talent is unreal. But you know what happens is everybody then is just watching and listening like we're all doing. But it means nobody's ringing.
It's a double-edged sword. So
yes,
we've got this great talent, but we don't have his phones ringing.
Yes.
So let's get all the phones ringing. Oh. So if you're not answering
stand
a call right now,
up,
please
stand up.
Come on.
And we've got a room full of phones also
there
behind
goes.
The curtain and downstairs.
We got our dancer.
Anybody stand up if you're not on the phone. We got to sum it up over here.
Oh, okay. One more.
We got to sum it up over there.
There we go.
Oh.
Stand up.
She's toying with us. She's toying with us. You can't trust that one.
Stand up.
So it's playing with us. So we got all these phones down. Now we've got another bank behind the curtain. 20 more phones are going to show us.
There we go.
Here we go.
2021.
Two to go.
We've got a couple to go, two to go. Thank you, Saskatchewan. This is absolutely
that's
incredible.
What we like to see. Ring
okay,
those phones.
Show your appreciation for this amazing Saskatchewan talent.
Ring those phones.
I love it.
Loving seeing the phones come down.
It.
And we've got them down. And we've got a total.
We've got a total. Come on, bring the numbers up.
Saskatchewan, help us. Shout them out.
Shout them out loud.
Two, one, four.
Saskatchewan.
Wow, thank you, Saskatchewan.
Okay, we're going to head down to Moose Jaw, I believe, with a little bit of a clip from the Moose Jaw Rockstars.
Hi, everyone. Jesse Harrison here. You might remember us from last year. This year at Tell a Miracle, however, we want to punch a hole through the sky. And along with this year is we made a sacrifice like Ironwood Family Fitness. And I shake my head. Now, let's all help kids together. Over to you, Austin.
Thanks, Jesse. We're doing our part with donut sales and taking your guys' donations. Thank you from Tell a Miracle.
Bring those phones.
Yo, what is up, guys? It's Sebastian from Moose Jaw ACT, and Moose Jaw ACT helped donate $1,000 last year, and they're helping us donate this year. My brother and I, we're hoping to punch a hole through the sky and triple our money this year of Tell a Miracle, and we want to just thank you guys for donating, and peace.
All right, peace. That's the Moose Jaw Rockstars. And a nice little clip from them. Okay, we've got the Martinsville and District Canets here. Now, who are you? Your first names?
Jody.
And
Bernice.
And Bernice, nice to have you here. Now, you guys have been busy all year long?
We have been very busy during the fall and winter, for sure we have been.
You bet.
A little bit different year than the past?
Very different.
Very different. Yeah.
Very different fundraisers, but we made it work.
Yeah, exactly. So that's the idea about reinventing what you've been doing for the last 2 years. And doing it in a different way.
You betcha. Mm-hmm.
And you've been pretty successful, I understand.
Yes.
We were.
Yeah, we were able to do a Santa parade that we raised quite a bit of money. So you gave a donation and Santa stopped at your house on the trailer that was all decorated.
Oh,
and you
nice.
Took a socially distanced picture.
Yeah.
And then we did a 50-50 and a raffle as well. So we were able to raise
$8,150.88.
Wow. Thank you again. Did you think that was even possible at the beginning
Honestly,
of the year?
No.
You thought it was all over with.
Yeah.
But people still can yep. come together yes. and figure yep. out ways to give back to Tell a Miracle.
Yeah, our community's been very awesome.
Yes,
this year.
They're an awesome area group and area of Martinsville and District Canets. Thank you so much for coming out.
You're very
and
welcome.
We'll work hard for next year, too.
Awesome. You betcha. Thank
okay.
you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you're sitting at home and wondering where some of this money goes that is raised right here on this very stage, let's meet 11-year-old Tyler.
So Tyler is 11 years old, and he was diagnosed at the age of 4 with autism, along with some other challenges. He struggles, you know, with his coordination. He doesn't have very good balance. His fine motor skills are delayed, and you know, he has other challenges. He can't talk or communicate quite as well, but he knows what he wants to say and he knows what he wants to do. And you know, that's where our occupational therapist has been so helpful in helping us to come up with these modified pieces of equipment that let him do the things that his friends can do.
Look at you! Are you ready to go fast, Tyler Wright? You ready to go fast?
We're always looking for ways to help keep Tyler active. You know, he sees what his peers are doing and isn't able to do all of those things. And so she was able to find this specialty bike that allows him to ride bikes just like all of his friends do. So about a year ago, we received a safety sleeper bed, and it is absolutely phenomenal. Tyler loves it. It keeps him enclosed. He's safe. He can grow into it for the next, you know, 20 years. And it's transportable. It folds down into a suitcase. And so we can now go visit family. We can see people we haven't been able to see before. The first 2 weeks we had that bed, he would race home from school up to his room and sit in there and play with his iPad and just be so thrilled. He would just sit there like this. Loves it.
Tell a Miracle is a huge part of my job as an occupational therapist because I am always looking for ways to help people, and that's often helping them find equipment or devices that will make their life easier. It would be so frustrating if we didn't have Tell a Miracle, because we know what can help these families, and the challenges for families don't go away.
With the help of the Tell a Miracle, we now can ride a bike, we now have a bed we can safely be in, we can travel. So it's made a quite profound difference in our quality of life. I can't express how thankful we are.
Hi, Bob here, and it's great to be back and see all of you.
even though I'm 3,500 miles from Saskatchewan, I can hear those phones ringing, and I know you're all having a great time. And I'm hoping my friends are there in the studio or watching from home calling in. And a very special shout out to my good buddies, Beverly, Brad, Jeff, and Andrea. I sure do miss your faces, especially when we used to sing one of my favorite songs that you might remember.
Go! Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face.
That's a good rehearsal. Now really sing it out.
Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face.
All right, now I promised Elmo and all the guys that I'd make sure you knew where all the parts of your face are. So when I sing about it, I want you to point to it really big.
Ready?
Here we go. No one has your lips. No one has your cheeks.
Cute.
No one has your nose. No one has your teeth.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
No one has your smile. No one has your dimple. No one has your knives. And no one has your pimple.
Your face, your face.
Let's hear it.
No one has your face.
Your face, your face. No one has your face. No one has your tongue. Stick them out. No one has your hair. No one has your ears. No one anywhere. No one has your forehead. No one has your chin. No one nowhere looks like you unless you have a twin. Anybody have a twin here?
Face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face.
Now let me see a happy face. Big smile. Let me see a sad face. Let me see a silly face. Let me see a mad face. Let me see a monster face. Let me see a laughing face. Let me see a crying face. Oh, so sad. Let me see a napping face. Go to sleep now. Wake up!
Your face, your face.
No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face. Your face, your face. No one has your face.
That was so good. Give your face a big hand. Well, I hope you're all having as much fun as we did being silly, making crazy faces. Boy, we sure had such great times over the years raising money for the people of Saskatchewan. So keep at it. Just ring those phones, ring those phones, ring those phones.
Oh, that's our Bob McGrath. Our
loved
faces
it,
are smiling, Bob.
Oh my
our
gosh,
faces
my cheeks are
smiling.
Sore from laughing.
We're like big children, aren't we? All over again. Oh, thank you. And you know what? He has a very good message. So please, if you're inspired by this, by all of the things you see here, ring those phones. Now, I would like to introduce another Saskatchewan talent from Weyburn. And this person, Autumn Alexander. Hello, Autumn. How are you today?
Hi, I'm good.
Great. Now, you have performed in Telemiracle in the past, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're going to be dancing for us again?
Yes.
And tell us a little bit about the dance.
This is a lyrical piece that I choreographed myself, and yeah, that's about it.
Amazing. That's not easy to choreograph, so that's a great skill. Thank you for bringing that to Telemiracle. Now, I hear that you also did some fundraising for us. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah. So I sold some of my art that I drew, like pen art, and so that made about half the donation, and then the rest was family and friends.
Wow. So you don't just dance, you draw and paint as well. So multi-talented yeah. woman, giving her talents to Telemiracle folks. So how much did you raise?
$2,000.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Well, thank you so much for your work. And, you know, that's $2,000 plus the Nutrien match, mm-hmm. which is $4,000. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Now let's watch our Weyburn's Autumn Alexander doing a dance for us. Thank you.
Thanks.
These years have taught me heartache and fame, a chance to change, a hope to be stronger, that beauty can smolder, a stage and a curtain, that nothing's for certain. Oh, this world has been hard on my bones. Oh, this ride has been hard. This God has brought me, what this God has taught me, passion and grace, how to stand in one space, laughing at lilies, what truth fills me, death on a cross, it was I that was lost, all this God has been life to these bones, yes this God.
And yet another beautiful performance. We've had just an entire show full of them this year.
They're so beautiful. And she choreographed that all by herself and raised $2,000, which Nutrien matched, of course. So now that's $4,000. They're matching up to $100,000 that SAS Talent brings in this through the whole telethon this year. And the way that they've raised the money, the SAS Talent, and these donations that are coming in have been absolutely amazing.
You know, yeah, and it's been incredible. And one thing I noticed this year is there's, you know, people doing their own choreography, people doing their writing their own songs. We have a lot of talent in this province and a lot of people to be proud of. Mm-hmm. Speaking of people to be proud of, I would like to tell you about our next bequest. This one comes from a man named Richard Allen Freeman. Dick was born in 1932 in Van, Saskatchewan. He left the family farm to work in Regina and married Elroy Dempsey in 1958. He began his working life as a welder and was the proud creator of Freeman's Welding. Finished his career as a gas inspector and after retirement, began driving bus. Sports were a part of Dick's youth and curling proved to be his passion. He proudly represented his club at the Saskatchewan Tankards several times. Dick and Elroy enjoyed dancing the night away after many curling club bonspiels around Regina. And when he was no longer active on the ice, he became a fan of the game on TV. Dick and Elroy loved to ring in the new year with an open house for family and friends. And another annual event in the Freeman household was Telemiracle. Dick would have the television on all night and day, waiting for just the right time to make his phone call and record his donation. Then he would be a fixture in his recliner until his name rolled through on the screen. He was very proud of that work, and he was very proud of the work that Tyler Miracle did for our province. Dick's friends and family are proud to carry on his tradition, and will certainly smile to see Dick Freeman's name on the big screen one more time. Dick passed away in 2020. The Kinsman Tell America would like to thank Dick for his generous gift of $2,500. Thank you, Dick.